Was that a pretty daunting task to try and make a wrestling program there?
Well, it had been a basketball school. There was a man by the name of John Burkett who they were beating some of the bigger schools. They beat West Waterloo one year, and it was all about basketball, and so it was from that standpoint you were kind of fighting an uphill battle, but had some good kids, and they worked hard early on, and we were able to get it going there. And I think one of the nice things about it, and I tell these younger coaches as they come in, of course we don't have too much of that anymore, but you come into a program that doesn't have a lot of people or a new program and said, well, you don't have to break bad habits because these guys learn someplace else, you know. And so I was able to, you know, put in things that I'd learned from Bob Siddons and Chuck Patton at UNI, and, you know, they bought into it, and we had some success, and then it was easier. Once we had some success, it was easier to get people involved.
Was a big validation that time when Ray Fox got a gold medal that you finally had a state champion?
Well, definitely. It's the kind of thing that, you know, once you break through the ceiling, so to speak, they realize it's possible that other people say, well, you know, one of ours has done that, so you know, we can have something to compare that to. And I think a real big turning point in there was when 78, when we qualified 10 wrestlers for the state, and we really didn't have a very good year or a very good tournament down there. We beat Lisbon in the districts, and they won state, and I think we ended up placing fifth or something like that. We didn't perform very well, and I guess we took that as a challenge, and the next year was when we qualified the whole team and won, you know, by roughly 100 points. At that point in time, I think that set the bar, and you know, people kept reaching for that bar all these years, and fortunately for the school and the teams and the coaches that were able to get to that bar a number of times.
How good of a coach would you have become, or would you have become a coach without Coach Siddons and Coach Patton putting a mark on you?
Well, I always wanted to be a coach. I started helping, you know, coach some of the Little League teams when I was 13 or 14 years old with a friend of my dad who had the team, and I helped him. And so I think that has always been in my blood, but I'm just so glad that I was fortunate to be in the right place at the right time, because they had a huge influence on not my desire to be a coach so much, but my ability to be a coach and to pick up the things that they have mastered as coaches and be able to carry that on.
What's maybe the one thing you're most proud of by yourself?
You know, there's just so many kids in so many different situations when you coach for 37 years that, you know, it'd be hard to single out one of them. But I think one of the things that kept me around as long as it did, my son graduated from high school in 1988. I've been coaching, you know, roughly 20 years. And, you know, there's a lot of time to put in. You know, coaches all over put in a lot of time. And I was thinking, and I was the athletic director, it seemed like I had enough to do. And so, well, my son's gone, and quite honestly, we lost a lot in the class of 88. You know, I knew we were going to have to start from square one again, because we had very little carryover, and it looked to be a pretty tough year. And, you know, those kids, although they were far from the most talented group, really inspired me, and I think that might have been one of the best coaching jobs I've ever done. We went 9-1. We got to the duels and we lost on a tiebreaker. But I mean, this had this group had a losing season, you know, written all over it before it came in. Like, I think geez, you know, if these guys can do that, if they can work that hard, you know, it kind of rejuvenated my hunger to keep coaching. Like, you know, you can help some of these kids. You can do some of these things. You can put smiles on their faces.
What kind of a job has Tom done?
Well, I go back from the beginning. You know, Tom's history. You talked about Ray Fox being the first gold medal, and Tom qualified and lost a real close match to the state champion first round, no wrestle back. A couple months later, after the season was over, he gets hit on by a drunken driver, and spends the next 3 to 4 months in a cast. I don't know if I've ever come across anybody that's had a better work ethic. Now, there's a lot of them up there, you know, that, you know, a Doug Ryder, for example, you know, whatever it is, you know, he does 110%.
Right.
You know? And, you know, that's the way Tom was, you know, and Tom was just work, and whatever was that, you know, and he never was in the school building because he got a job and eventually moved up to management in the construction line, and quite honestly couldn't afford to go back to teach school. You know, that just wasn't, but he had worked for people that had given him the leeway to do some of these things, and he really wasn't crazy about, when I talked to him when I was leaving, that he wasn't really crazy about it, you know. And I said, Tom, you know, you're the one that I trust with it. You know, I know you, and you know, and you know, at least try it. And you know, that's, this is, I had a lot of confidence in him. You know, the tough part about for him or any coach is out of the building, because wrestling is such a type of thing, you need somebody. Fortunately, Ray worked construction too, but he got laid off in the winter, so he would come around, hang around school, and kind of fill in Kepman on what was going on from the school side. So
sure,
they made a great team. I don't know currently, but I know in recent years when they were doing well that there's probably 75 boys or less in the school, and 30 some of them are out for wrestling. And when I look down over the roster the last few years, that I think last year when I looked at it, that not this year, but the previous year, that I had either coached or taught one or both of the parents of all those kids. So it's not like they had an influx of kids flocking in because Don Bosco has a name and a good program and everybody wants to go there. That isn't happening. Okay.
It's the roots.
Yeah. You know, those kids and their parents, you know, in the community, there's tremendous support in the community. You know, kids grow up wanting, at this point in time, wanting to be a Don Bosco wrestler if they're interested in wrestling at all, and they know that you know, it's a quality program, and they know what's expected of them. They come in there, they know they're going to have to work hard.